Welcome to DV Workshop channel. Today we will discuss a Python program. This is a small program we have written in Python, and I will try to run this. So I navigate to our command prompt, and I will write py, then name of the program. Okay, here's the output. So let's discuss this program. First of all, we have import tkinter library as tk, and then we have import time library, and then we have created a list having different colors stored in it, and then we have a variable r assigned to 0, and then we have a for loop for C in colors. So first of all, it will traverse this list, and for first iteration C would have a value red, and then it would have a green, and then orange, and then white goes on. Let's see this demonstration. So in first iteration we have color equal to red, and then color equal to green, and color equal to orange, and goes on. So here I have written the print statement over here, and it is just printing us the value of the C in each iteration of for loop. So it's just printing these values in console because I have written a time.sleep 1 second, so that's why it is just delaying the output, and then it is printing slowly, and at last it just created this UI. So let's discuss this one. TK.label, label is a kind of label we can create in this UI. So first of all, the text in a label would be C. That means C is the red over here, because when we ran it for the first iteration, the C have a value red because we are printing C over here, color equal to C. So that means color equal to red. Now in this label we are putting text equal to C. So here it is. This is a label over here, and text we are putting red. That is a value of C. And then relief. This is a 3D effect. What kind of effect we want on this label? So it could be raised or other kind of effects we could have. Next one is a width. So we want to set a width of this label. So right now R is 0, and this is the first iteration. So that's why width is set to 0, so that's why width of this label is very less. The next one is a grid. So here this screen is a grid, overall grid we have, and now we have a two columns here, and we have a few rows over here. So for example, this is first row, and then this one is a second row, and then third row and fourth row, so goes on. So the first one is a zero row, and then one row, and then two row, and then goes on. And now we have a two columns over here, column 0 and column 1. So now it will create a grid for us, and then it will display the items based upon a grid. For example, the first item, first label we are printing over here is in the row 0 and column 0. So row 0 and column 0 is at this place over here, so that's why it put red over here. And second one is an entry. Entry is nothing but a text box. So right now it has created this small text box over here, and I can write text in it. So now it is telling that what kind of background color we want. So we have created BZ equal to C, and we already know that C has a value red, so It just created a text box with the background color red. And then effect, what kind of 3D effect we want in this text box. So it is raised, so it just created a text box with a raised effect. And now width, so because R is 0 now, so width is 10 into 0, that means 0 width it created. And now here the row is 0 but column is 1, so that's why it just take it to the next place. Here we have a 0 0, and here we have a 0 1, because this is a row number 0, and here we have a row 0, and here we have a row 0 and column 1. Here we have a row 0, column 0. Here we have a row 0, column 1. We have a increment. So we have incremented the value of R, and we have put the sleep over here for 1 second, and then this loop repeats. In second iteration, as we see in the second iteration over here, we have a color equal to green. So we just pick the value of green here, and then it will type the green over here. And then width this time is 15 into 1, because now we have a R equal to 1, so we got a width of 15. So here we have a green with the label with the green written over there, and width is 15. Now the same thing for this text box also, its background color is green because green is written over there. So C contains green, so that's why background color is green, and it is a 3D effect on this text box. And then width is 10 into 1, that means 10 is the width of this text box. So we call it entry in Python. And again we have a grid function over here, so where to place this item. So here we have a row equal to 1 and column equal to 1, so this is row number 1 and column number 1. So row number 1, column number 1 is a place over here, and row 1 and column 0 is a place over here. So that's why the label is placed at row 1, column 0, and entry, that is the text box, is placed at row 1, column 1. And then we repeat this loop for all the items. So here we have printed all the items over here. So let's run this program again. This is the first iteration of loop, and then second, and then fourth. So it is iterating for all the colors, that is for all the items in color list, and then it is printing these labels and these text boxes in grid. So these are just text boxes. We could write anything over here. That's all. Thank you very much.